In this video, Sundowns need to keep Shalulile at all costs, Hunt's defensive problems continue, Zuma gives Hunt a transfer headache as Super Subs save the day. Welcome back to AfriFootball. This is our 3 things you learned from Mamelodi Sundowns vs Kaizer Chiefs game. We'll be doing these videos for all Kaizer Chiefs matches going forward, so remember to like and subscribe. Let's get started. The absence of Peter Shalulile in Mamelodi Sundowns lineup was heavily noticed. Gift Motupa started in his place, but this came with some problems on it. For the most part, Motupa was okay, but he lacked the pace, mobility and positioning that Shalulile brings to the team. Hence, this is why we're saying Sundowns should do everything to keep Shalulile at bay. But with the acquisition of Slovakian Safranco, it's safe to say that the three wise men at Sundowns are looking to the future, in case anything should happen between Shalulile and his rumored move to El Ahly. We covered this rumor in a previous video and we'll link it in the comments below, so do make sure you check it out after this video. Moving on to our next story. Towards the close of the first half, the infamous defensive department of Chiefs showed us why it needs to be invested in. After an impressive link-up play between Zwane, Motupa and the goal scorer Cirino, the defensive department literally shut down and left us wondering what they were doing. This was embarrassing because they left Kune to fend for himself. Recently reported that Chiefs has been linked with Kowo of the Due Birds. And if the first goal is not good reason, then what is a compelling reason for Chiefs to sign these Swallows players? We covered Kowo in one of our transfer videos. We'll also link that down below, so do make sure you check it out. And if you're enjoying this content, remember to like and subscribe to the page because we give you informative transfer news and we link it to our post-match analysis. And we're trying to get 5,000 subscribers, so you doing that will be definitely helping us. And moving on to the final thing we noticed from this match. Zuma has given Hunt a transfer headache as the Super Subs saved the day. The two players who came on and changed this game were Zuma and Nurkovic. Zuma came in as an unlikely sub after Kamba Biliat was injured. Zuma has been in the transfer news consistently in the past few weeks and we've covered him in several videos, while Nurkovic was a surprise bench starter in this match. Nurkovic-Biliat combination is what we tipped as the best partnership for Kaizer Chiefs, but the Zuma-Nurkovic link-up with Sinestro isn't looking all too bad. In this game, Zuma offered up a surprising attacking option for Chiefs. And this may mean Gavin Hunt may have to reconsider the swap deal that they've been negotiating with the Due Birds from Kowo, as we have earlier reported in one of our transfer videos. Do you think Chiefs should offer up Zuma from Kowo, now that he has shown that he can be an asset for Kaizer Chiefs in their times of need? Or do you think they should still go on with the swap deal? As Chiefs may need a defensive uplift? Let us know in the comments below. This has been AfriFootball. Do tell us if you want us to make longer post-match videos. We'll see you in the next one.